Hi everyone. So we have talked a lot about JavaScript. Now let's have a look on ES6 features. That might be the questions like what all ES6 features, what is arrow function, what is spread operator, rest parameter, what are the new collection types added in ES6 like set, map, weak set, weak map, right? What is the default parameter, template strings and all these things. Okay, spread operator. Where spread operator in the arrays you can use to actually concat two different arrays, like third group, first group is which is an array. You want it to concat, you can actually destructure this array and add it as an index. Similarly, destructuring of object and array can be done with this triple dot operator. And this also used in the rest parameter. While you have a function, you want it to pass multiple arguments. So while calling this function, you can use dot 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 object dot 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 array. So we have a set map. Set actually stores the unique values. So if you wanted to remove the duplicates from an array, or you wanted to just store the unique indexes, then you can use set as a collection. Default argument, if you don't want it to call add function with x, then always it will keep the default value 10 and 20. You might have already seen these things. Here we are passing 30, 40, so it will override the x with 30 and y with 40. And similarly, how we are creating the objects and calling the methods. Arrow function, which is an important one. Earlier we were writing the functions like this. Now you can write it in a single line. Okay, if there are no arguments, then you can just simply put empty brackets. If there are argument, you can just put that argument without brackets. Okay, arrow function is useful because with the help of arrow function, you will be able to access the outer scope object. So here in this particular thing where you have a inner function, in the inner function we are not able to access this object. So what we do is we assign another variable underscore this and we are able to access it. With the arrow functions you don't have this kind of problem. Using this dot first, if you are using arrow function here, if you just replace it with this arrow function, then you don't need to do this alias. You can directly access this dot first. Okay, the only difference why you don't have to explicitly bind inner functions with this object, you can just use arrow function. It will provide a lexical this binding means with the arrow function it is able to access the scope whatever is defined immediately outer side. So whatever the scope, current scope which is defined here, this scope, because here I can access this. So if I just use the arrow function here, it means I can access whatever the scope available here inside this also. Okay, then we have a lot of things about objects, like there is a for in loop to iterate object, for of loop used to iterate the collections. Here we have a generators and iterators, and symbol is a new type in JavaScript. Okay, so generator is a function which start with asterisk, it will return the iterable object, and this iterable object you can call dot next to get the values until unless this start coming as a undefined and null as a true. Okay, you can create a simple iterator from a string also using title, a simple dot iterator, and you can do a dot next value. It will just keep returning the value until unless it will start getting undefined. Okay, many ES6 features and all. Now if we just talk about simple promises, how we define a simple promises in JavaScript. Because in interviews, they will not ask you what is callback, what is promise, what is async await. They will give you a callback, convert it into a promise. They will give you a promise, convert it into a async await, right? The simple promise, we simply write like this. It is returning a ES6 class, which is native to JavaScript now. And there is a set timeout. After 1000 milliseconds, it will resolve. So we are getting the resolved promise. So when you do a dot, then this callback will execute. Okay. So if you just try to convert this into a simple async await, delay can be a simple promise. Okay, and we can actually, let's say how, so delay is a promise, right? So I can write a function or const async await function just for practice. Here I have async function. So if you are using await, then always wrap it a function with the async. So here I'm using await delay, okay, for 2 seconds, then await delay for 5 seconds, right? So whatever it is, I mean, even if you are writing a simple function, async function hello, right, await should be there. So await, async can exist without await. You can actually return a simple, consider that you are writing a function hello. Okay, here you can return a simple value, but it's not advised. This is nothing but it is returning a promise, and it can be called as it's a resolved promise with the value 1. Okay, we can talk about simple fetch. Fetch is actually a JavaScript utility to get the data. So like get tuples, and how we do it, we do a simple fetch using fetch, this is my URL. Okay, on top of that it is actually returning a promise. So we got response, and we have to do response.json. Okay, and then you can do dot then again to get the data out of it, or you can just return this like this. So whenever you are calling this function get peoples, you can actually do a dot then there, and this is the data you are getting. So if we have a simple task, okay, convert this into async await. How we can do? Simple, what we will do is we will just write our function const get data. Okay, if you want to write it in the async await way, you can also do that. Some argument also you are passing like name. So if you are writing async await, then it's advised that you should wrap it inside a try catch, because await is like a single line statement and we can't track the errors if that is coming. So it's better to wrap it inside a try catch. And here we will directly get a response, because what we are doing, await fetch, and this is my URL, some URL blah blah. And here we can also pass a dynamic data, like I'm passing name. So what this will do is this will give me the response. Now I will get the JSON from here. Also I can do await response dot JSON. I have to call to get the data, and const list, final list, here I will get the actual data. This JSON contains the response from the API in JSON object. I can do a map, and I know what is the format of the data I'm getting, so I can just users or something. That depends on what kind of API you are writing, and you can return a list. Okay, simply this is how we can write, and this get data you can directly call, because this is async function, you can directly call it get data. And if you are calling this something like this function, async function, async function get data. So now it is async function, so you have to call it in the await wrapper. So here I will be writing another function get result or whatever it is. Here I have to do await, and you can make it as async function again. So what your choice, this await you can call directly, okay, or you can also wrap it inside another functions. And here we are doing get data. So get data is actually a sync function, you have to put await, and we are returning this. Okay, so this is simple async await analogy. I mean, you can be given a promise chain, convert it into async await, how the async await runs parallelly and sequentially. Now one simple problem is this, which we forgot to talk about. So this delay, This delay is a promise. Let's talk about this. Okay. Now, if you are doing it something like this, delay 2, 5, here you, let's say you are putting 7. So, first it will execute, then you have to wait. Then it will execute, then you have to wait. How can we get rid of this? Either you use promise.all or all these things, but there is a catch you can apply. Actually, you can get a promise p, const p1, by just calling this delay function and hold on to this promise. Similarly, you will get another promises. So these statements will not wait for anything. They will calculate their promises, which may be in the pending state. And then you can actually do await p1, await p2, await p3. This is just a way of optimizing things. Here you are awaiting, so after every await, you are actually waiting for that much duration. Here you got all the promises first and then you just await together. So it's like you indirectly, you are executing all these three promises together in the parallel form. Okay, that's it. Thanks everyone.